back at the Humboldt Hill job, taking out this aquadam tomorrow. Been here approximately 2 weeks. Almost no seepage underneath the aquadam. Now to the other side of the road. This is the opposite side of the road, the downstream side. Discharge pump is pumping the water coming from the upstream to the downstream using this pump. This is where the water is coming out at. Approximately 4 feet deep. Oh, look at this. They widened this hole out considerably. They have dug right up to the side of the aquadam. They've got their dewatering pumps turned off. Aquadam worked just great, formed perfect to the contour of the ground. Job well done. Out comes the aquadams tomorrow. Here we are at 8 o'clock on a Thursday morning to take out these aquadams that have been in it roughly 2 weeks. Their culverts have been cleaned and refurbished, and they're ready to call this job done. As soon as we take out the aquadams, it will be done. So to take these aquadams out, of course, when we take the water out, the aquadam's going to get wider, and this edge will be over because they dug a ditch right next to it. The aquadam will be in the ditch. So to compensate for this, we're going to fill the ditch up with water so it pushes on the aquadam. Otherwise, the aquadam might end up on these rocks right here, which are very jagged and will just cause the aquadam to get a hole in it. So we're going to try and avoid that. Of course, this hole goes all the way underneath the road, and there's a hole on the other side. This is the other side of the road. Of course, it has to fill in also to help take this aquadam out, because they dug a ditch right here alongside of it. And we don't want it to roll down into that ditch when we take all the water out of it. So this is a precautionary measure. Our bypass pump is still working. That's our bypass pump. The hole's filling in. We got a ways to go. The water here needs to be the same height as here. So we've got a little bit to go. So now we're pumping out of the inside of the aquadam. We have two pumps set up. One, two. And by the time we pump some water out of the aquadam, this pool here will be at the same height as the water on the outside, and we'll keep the aquadam from being pushed into this big hole where all that big rock is. Now once the water gets down to this level, we can start rolling up the aquadam. This is the other side of the bridge. And we're going to start pumping the water out of it right now, too. Now it's time we put a new beam in there that's stronger. The aquadam came with the sides folded in. You can't fold the sides in and twist the water out at the same time. So we had to bring longer beams. We had to double the beam. So we're using 2 4x6s, 24 feet long, so that we have enough beef in the beam to pick this aquadam up, even if it's got some water in it. So it's time to roll her up a little bit. Go ahead. Together. They go forward together.
And then one back.
One goes back. And then the other one goes back. Then both forward together. One goes back. As the other one holds, then he goes back. Both go forward together.
I think we're about to
Well, this pool here is a little bit higher than the water out here, so we're now going to take the hoses that's pumping out of the aquadam and put it to the outside instead of putting it in here and making this water depth higher. the other side of the road. We've been pumping water in here, but of course it's full like the other side is, and it's time to put the water back out into the greater wetlands. You can see the indention that the aquedam left. All the grass is pushed over. It certainly not, it has not killed the grass. But if it was there for months, it probably would. But this was only here for 2 weeks. All this grass will be as good as new in a week or two. And there you go. This is how you, this is what underneath the aquedam it looks like. Here's a crew member working hard on removing the aquedam. Of course, the water's been pumped down. All of this doesn't have any water in it except for little pockets of quarter inch deep. You can see this side of the aquedam, the water's as high as this side of the aquedam. The water's holding the aquedam in place so it doesn't roll down that bank into that hole that they dug right next to it. We continue to pump out water from the aquedam. Well, the suction hoses are sucking air because they're not shoved into the bag far enough, so they're not shoved into the aquedam far enough, so we are going to have to shove them in there a little further to stay up with the drop in the water elevation. Again, that wasn't a very good plan. Yeah, those hoses were plenty long to start with, but now they're not long enough. So that was a misstep by myself in not bringing longer hoses. But we'll make this work. We've been pumping on this dam with two pumps for approximately an hour, 15 minutes. The water level is almost equal to the surrounding water. We're gonna fire up the excavator over here. And we're gonna have him help us in rolling up this aquedam and removing it. Gonna move the aquedam back here just a hair, straighten out the beam. That straightened out our beam so we can roll it now.
Good?
Yep. So roll her up. Okay, Matt.
Here, shake it. Yeah, you get the longer side. Yeah, well, this is the harder side. You were being a sissy over here before.
Hey, that's fucking hard. You don't know me.
Yeah, that was hard, wasn't it? Okay, that's it for the time being.
Are you gonna wrap it up?
No, we need him to grab that corner and pull it back again. Water still being pumped out of the aqua dam. You can see it coming out over here. We're going to have the excavator tweak this way. We're going to have him pull the other end back. Now the beam's straight. Now we're going to take this ratchet off, and we're going to push on the beam and push it through at least 12 inches. Well, go see where he can see you. You're not doing any good standing looking at it. How much more? There it is. Gonna put the ratchets back on. Hey. Let's go. Yeah. Take your ratchets off, put that strap on. Easy, easy. Whoa, he's gonna break it.
Bending the beam, huh?
Yeah, just wait. No more pressure. So I gotta pump more water out or we're gonna break that beam if I keep pulling on it like this. So the whole thing's coming. You can see it, it's just very, very slow. A little bit at a time. Of course, this bank is going to pull into the water, and then all the water will come off and all the pressure will be gone as soon as that happens. We're not quite there with pumping the water out of the aquadam. Gonna let the pumps work a little while longer. There we go, it's just pulling off the bank. The whole thing will slide out now. Now all the water that's remaining will be coming out the end. You see all this clear water here came out of the bag here, and the brown water was the water that was around the bag. Time to slow down. That's it right there.
Want them to pull back a little further so we'll end up getting out of the water?
Okay, keep going. Yay! Yeah, go all the way up to where you're standing. This aqua dam is 100% savable. And we just pulled it out, dewatered it. The raining water simply came out the end. There's one of them. Now we got one more aqua dam to do. We got to finish rolling this one up, which we're going to do right now. Well, it's back to ratcheting it using the ratchets and manpower. We've taken the strap off right here. We're going to use the excavator again in a second.
Yeah, we're going to pull it.
Good, do it. Do it. Going to straighten up the beam.
Oh.
There it is.
Can you hear
it
cracking?
Yep, that's it. Having pushed the beam through.
I don't think we have a lot of room on that side, do we?
Yeah, we do.
Yep.
Now go tell him what you want. The other side, not this side.
Oh.
No, you can leave just the bar. You're going to push that beam in a little bit.
That's not good, right?
Now we're going to roll her up some more. Both together. So here at the last, we're simply going to fold this side over so it'll get rolled up on this beam and we won't have to fight it. There it is, that's it. On this side has to go forward a couple feet so that it's square with the aqua dam.
That's about right.
Okay, there it is. Now it's square with the rest of the material that needs to be rolled up. Okay, let's do it again. It's too much for two people, so we're using the excavator very gently to finish rolling this dam up. Now this is where people start putting holes into the dam when they start using equipment. The equipment can't fill if that dam's gonna rip or nothing, so you gotta go very easy with the equipment. Yeah. Yes, the easy way is to do nothing and let the equipment do it. But that just puts holes in the aqua dam and leaves a big ball. This way, it's a nice tight roll. One more roll. Okay, time for ropes.
Rope.
You can still see the water trickling out from that roll. Because we pulled it up a hill, the hill took out most of the water. Simply pulling it up out of that hole, which is there. This is what's left of the work area on this side of the road. Everything looks great. The ground here, you can't even see where the aqua dam was, hardly, and it'll be back to where you can't tell the aqua dam was even here in a matter of weeks. Now, after we put ropes down, we're gonna roll the aqua dam over onto the ropes. There's one rope here, one rope here. Okay. After pulling the rope taut, we put one knot in it. Now we've doubled this rope because this dam's gonna be heavy. This is half inch polyethylene rope. Okay, good enough. Now we put a loop in it up here.
How high you want the loop?
The same as his. Okay, now hopefully that bucket will be able to pick it up. You got to remove before we pick it up, we have to remove these, okay, help him get it. No, we're gonna set it over there and we're gonna go to work on the other side. She's ready, mobile and ready for transport. Good job. From start to finish, this aqua dam took about 2.5 hours from the time we arrived. And of course, the one on the other side is already being pumped down. Well, we only got one pump running in this dam here. And it's not sucking at the moment. So now we're gonna work on this dam, getting it out so it's reusable. it. There's one dam loaded. We pumped the aqua dam down quite a bit. We're going to start rolling it up. That'll force all the water to this end. Okay, wait a second now, wait a second. One holds while the other one goes back, then the other one goes back, and they both go forward together. Teamwork. Now, the reason there's so much water inside this aqua dam is because of this pipe right here. It won't let the water drain out downhill to the greater body of water. It's a little rise there. So this water's trapped here behind this pipe, and we have to manually twist it to the front so the pumps can pick up on it. Well, you can see water just started going over the top of the aqua dam. We've pumped it down so much that this water out here is in the same height is higher than the water on the other side of the aqua dam, so it's gone across this way. And here, we put a strap around the end of it here so we can pick up on it using the excavator. We're going to pull the whole thing up through here and stretch it out. That way we won't have to pump anymore, but we had to pump most of the water out. Now it's just out.
Huh?
Out. Now we've got the whole dam straight here. Thank you. are trying to set this end in the water. Got to remove the strap so the end of the bag opens up.
Want to untie it off the bucket too?
Yes. Well, we've been at this for some time now. This little ditch here, that's about 2 feet deep. Of course, the water don't want to come out of that using the pump. So we had a heck of a time. Now we've been pulling on this, and we're gonna pull some more. We're gonna drag it into this bigger hole, which is great because it'll float. This little hillside there gave us quite the little fit there. Now let's don't drag it up those rocks. Whoa, whoa. See the water just going in the.
Now do we gotta turn that thing around?
No, we can do it, back at the office. I mean at the yard.
Okay, so we're just gonna slop it up.
Yep. Yep. You have to get off there now. Look out, guys, look out. Slow! Slow! No, he's got to keep pulling it all the way out.
Well, he was evening it out.
Oh, okay.
You know, because it was hanging there.
Now, is it going to hang up on anything over there?
Nothing yet.
Now, he needs to flop that whole thing around. And all the water comes out the end. That's why we like one end open. There it is, all the water's out. And we're gonna pull this out in that field and roll it up. There's a concrete chunk with a piece of iron in it. If we go over that, it's just sure to rip the bottom of the aquadam. So we're removing it. Good eye by somebody.
This young man right here. There you go.
we don't want to go over those two right there. Here, knock that rock out of there. Okay. Gonna turn the Aqua Dam over, he says, because it's the way we. This guy's good. This guy's real good on that machine. He got her turned over just like he said he was going to. All right.
Are you gonna pull it?
This is air trapped inside the Aqua Dam, is what this ball of that's air.
Push on this end a little bit, I think. Yeah, like there. It should straighten out. Okay, now
straight. Tremendous amount of torque is being delivered by the two people on each end with those cheater bars. And that helps tremendously to keep this in a nice roll instead of just pushed up into a ball. Slow it goes it. That's the name of the thing. It's got to go slow. Well, there we are. Now we'll get this back to the shop, blow it up with air, go through it, make sure it's got no holes in it, patch the holes we find. We know there's no knife wounds in it, so this dam is 100% reusable. This is the next time will be number 3 for this dam. See all the water still coming out.
Right like that. Okay, let's put rope, right?
Oh, look at this. Beautiful.
Aqua Dam number two. Ready to roll.
Right here in front of me.
We use half inch polyethylene rope, trucker's rope, and we've got each side doubled. And that will lift up this Aqua Dam. Dry weight is 1,300 pounds. Yep. Two Aqua Dams. Thank you very much.
Good job.
We got to pick up our pumps and we'll be out of here. Well, we're done with the Aqua Dam part of this project. The Aqua Dam was going right through there. And of course the brush got pushed down, but they come from a bulb, and the bulb's still there, unhurt. Everything will come back lickety split. This is the downstream side. The two Aqua Dams on a 24 foot trailer. That's right.
Yeah, but he's about 12 or 15 years into being tired of freaking looking at black plastic.
Pays the same. We gotta grab that right there.
What?
We gotta grab that tarp right there if you can. This is the project on Humboldt Hill, Eureka, California. The culvert's in place. It's only been a week, and already the green aquatic plants have kind of taken over. The highway's been repaved. Over to this side, the downstream side. This is where the Aqua Dam was sitting. All these tubular aquatic plants will regenerate themselves in a matter of weeks. You can already see the green sprouts coming up. This will be green again in no time. This whole pool here will be covered in some type of green floating aquatic plants. So this is the end of this job. The whole job took less than 2 weeks.